America went through a deadly anthrax scare a number of years ago, scientists had their eyes on Flagstaff. It was researcher Paul Keim who identified the anthrax strain. On this next Inside NAU Science segment, we'll feature Paul Keim and his genetic discoveries.
The way I like to think about DNA is DNA is just information, and it's enormous amounts of information. If you were to take the human genome, for example, and just print it in a normal, 11-point font and print it on a page, you're talking about a million pages to write out the human genome. Behind me here is a robot, and this is a robot that is able to handle thousands and thousands of samples of DNA in a matter of just a couple of hours. So you can think of that a lot of different ways. We could take DNA from a single person, for example, and run thousands of tests on it in an hour with this robot, or we could take 1,000 samples and run one test against it. So it gives us the power of numbers. Automation gives us the power of numbers so that we're able to increase our throughput. Now, why that's important is because the DNA sequencer that you're going to see is able to analyze the sequence of the DNA in a very rapid fashion. This thing can do enormous number of analyses in an hour, in a day. It'll work all night, never complain. It's all automated, and so we need the robotics to feed it so that we can get those analyses done. One of the big barriers that had to be overcome in sequencing the human genome was computational power. It was necessary to actually push computers to a new level in order to do the analysis that was necessary to finish the human genome. Now, we work on much smaller organisms. Bacteria tend to have 1,000th of the DNA of humans. And because of that, we don't need to have the extremely large computers to do what we do. But nevertheless, the workstations and the very high-end tabletop computers that we have are frequently maxed out. And of course, you know that all of your genes reside in DNA, and so it's the information in those genes that give you blue eyes, blonde hair, dark hair, pigmentation in your skin. I mean, that's all due to the information that's back in the DNA. It's my opinion, it's time to shift our technology away from just the human genome and start focusing on the DNA of these other organisms that cause diseases. So if we take that technology, we can very precisely, very quickly, and very accurately go in and look at a disease-causing organism like E. coli, Salmonella, these are foodborne pathogens, or diseases that might cause pneumonia or sepsis. If we look at their DNA, first off, we identify them very precisely as being a disease-causing organism, and secondly, we start to characterize what their biological properties are. Are they resistant to tetracycline or penicillin? And hence get that information out, and then rapidly get it to physicians. If we can rapidly get it to physicians, we can affect the way that they treat a particular disease and what therapeutics they might use. So current methods are really go back all the way to Pasteur. And when you're infected with something, they take a sample, they take it down to the laboratory, and they try to culture it. They try to grow it in sterile techniques so that, one day, 2 days, maybe 4 days later, the physicians might get something back from the laboratory that says it's a yeast infection, it's an E. coli infection. Obviously, they start to treat you right away. They don't just send you away and say, come back when the test comes in. 2 days, 4 days later, they might have to change that therapeutic regime that they put you on because they didn't know exactly what you were infected with. So if we can cut those 2 day, 4 day waits out, first off, you have a much better chance of recovering quickly. And of course, that could save the healthcare system 2 to 4 days of hospitalization, which runs into the tens of thousands of dollars. So rapid analysis, very precise and exact information, seems trivial these days, but it is exactly what we need to lower healthcare costs and to save lives and to increase the quality of our healthcare.
Find out about the research at Northern Arizona University. Check us out online.